I'll give you one key. This key, if you implement it in your salah, inshallah ta'ala, it will make your salah even sweeter. Three statements. Remember these three statements. Speak to him. Conversate with him. Ask him. Speak to Allah. Conversate with Allah. Ask Allah. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu arda. He says that the Prophet alayhi salatu salam said, that one of you, when he enters the prayer, فَإِنَّمَا يُنَاجِي رَبَّهِ, he's conversating with his Lord.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين وإذ قال إبراهيم رب اجعل هذا البلد آمنا واجنبني وبني أن نعبد الأصنام رب إنهن أضللن كثيرا من الناس فمن تبعني فإنه مني ومن عصاني فإنك غفور رحيم ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون ربنا إنك تعلم ما نخفي وما نعلن وما يخفى على الله من شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء الحمد لله الذي وهب لي على الكبر إسماعيل وإسحاق إن ربي لسميع الدعاء رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب ولا تحسبن الله غافلا عما يعمل الظالمون إنما يؤخرهم ليوم تشخص فيه الأبصار مهطعين مقنعي رؤوسهم لا يرتد إليهم طرفهم وأفئدتهم هواء وأنذر الناس يوم يأتيهم العذاب فيقول الذين ظلموا ربنا أخرنا إلى أجل قريب نجب دعوتك ونتبع الرسل أولم تكونوا أقسمتم من قبل ما لكم من زوال وسكنتم في مساكن الذين ظلموا أنفسهم وتبين لكم كيف فعلنا بهم وضربنا لكم الأمثال وقد مكروا مكرهم وعند الله مكرهم وإن كان مكرهم لتزول منه الجبال فلا تحسبن الله مخلف وعده رسله إن الله عزيز ذو انتقام يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات وبرزوا لله الواحد القهار وترى المجرمين يومئذ مقرنين في الأصفاد سرابيلهم من قطران وتغشى وجوههم النار ليجزي الله كل نفس ما كسبت إن الله سريع الحساب هذا بلاغ للناس ولينذروا به وليعلموا أنما هو إله واحد وليذكر أولو الألباب.
لن نطيل عليكم إن شاء الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. After praising Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala and sending salutation upon our Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, we proceed. Alhamdulillah that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has gathered us here once again, and I'm glad to be here, Mr. Furqan, after many months. It's been a while since I've come here, and every time I do come here, it brings a lot of joy to my heart. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, seeing all your wonderful faces and seeing all the congregation who are here for Salat al-Fajr, seeking the pleasure of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala and wanting to hear the speech of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala and to learn the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal. We ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, just like united us here, that he unites us in Jannah Firdaws al-A'la without any previous punishment or difficult account. Ayyuha al-Ikhwa, first of all, I came because I wanted to hear Sheikh Muhammad Ali today. So I sat at the back, so I'm hoping that he wouldn't know that I'm here. But Sheikh Muhammad Ali, he has cameras, I think, everywhere that allow him to see who's here and who's not here. Allah al-Musta'an. But Ayyuha al-Ikhwa, the ayat that I recited, in the Salah, there's maybe one ayah or two ayahs that I want to just mention a bit about, and then inshallah ta'ala we'll conclude. In the first rak'ah, we recite the ayat from Surah Ibrahim, where Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala talks about Ibrahim alayhi salam and some of the du'as that Ibrahim alayhi salam he made. And amongst the du'as that Ibrahim alayhi salam he made, that Allah narrates to us, it is that he said, رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابِ. He said, my Lord, Ibrahim alayhi salam, who's a messenger of Allah, who's a prophet of Allah, who's amongst the most beloved to Allah, he says, my Lord, make me from those who establish the prayer, who observe the prayer, who perfect their prayers, and my offspring. Ibrahim alayhi salam is making that dua. That was the custom of the prophets and the messengers and the righteous. So they constantly ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to help them perfect their salah. When I was waiting for Salat al-Fajr, I saw on the screen a hadith which inspired me to read these ayat and to talk about this. The hadith, it said that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, بين الرجل وبين الشرك أو الكفر ترك الصلاة. Between a man and disbelief or polytheism, it is the abandonment of the prayer. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he told us that the matter of the salah, it's a huge deal. Imagine that you're going to stand in front of a king in this world. And this king, you're going to meet him, and you're told prior to the meeting that you are going to be asked one question by that king. If you get the answer right to that question, you'll be rewarded. But if you get the answer wrong, you'll be punished and doomed and imprisoned and tortured if you get that one question wrong. How are you going to be prior to that meeting? You're going to be stressed about that question. You're going to take that question very seriously. You're constantly going to be thinking about it, right? The Prophet ﷺ told us every single one of us is going to stand in front of Allah ta'ala. And he's going to be asked one question. If he gets the answer to that question right, everything after will be fine. The Prophet ﷺ told us that the question is, he said, أَوَّلُ مَا يُحَاسَبُ بِهِ الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الصَّلَاةِ. The first matter the slave is going to be questioned about in the Day of Judgment is the Salah. If it's sound, everything after that will be sound and fine. If it's not, then everything after that, well, he will be doomed. And he will be in punishment by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala due to the Salah. It's the most important thing. The ulama, they take from the hadith that the key to your righteous deeds being accepted by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the Salah. If it's not intact, your other righteous deeds do not matter. But that's not exactly what I wanted to mention, because you people are people of Salah. You are people who come to the house of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. You are those who are constantly frequenting the house of Allah Azza wa Jal. But ayyuhal ikhwa, you know this salah that we pray, it is not just a prayer that we have to do. Rather, it has something in it that is extra, that is special. If we manage to unlock that, we will taste that sweetness of the salah. Ibn Qayyim alayhi rahmatullah, he says the salah, it has ladha, it has sweetness, it has enjoyment. The one who unlocks that sweetness and enjoyment of the prayer, he enters a paradise before the actual paradise in the hereafter. That experience of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ, the coolness of my eyes have been placed in the salah. And he will say, أَرِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَال, cool the iqama so that we can pray, enjoy the salah, and find contentment and happiness and solace and comfort in that prayer. What is the experience they found? Thabit al-Bunani alayhi rahmatullah, he said, I saw Abdullah ibn Zubayr radiyallahu anhu praying by the Kaaba, and it's as if he was a tree. Still, the birds would be on his head, they would be moving, he would be in each position for a long period of time. Why is it that they spend so much time in the salah? Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah tabarak wa ta'ala said that after salat al-Maghrib, he prayed the sunnah after Maghrib, and he went to sujood, and he never raised his head from sujood until the adhan of Isha was called. How was he able to spend so much time in that sujood? They found something in their prayer, that sweetness, that if we unlock it, we'll be the exact same. They were not superheroes, or they didn't have superpowers that allowed them to do this. They were just like me and you, but they made the effort to unlock this sweetness. And then the most enjoyable thing on this earth for them was the salah. So how can we experience that? Ayyuhal ikhwa, I'll tell you a thing. Our uncle, the Mu'adhin, may Allah Azza wa Jalla bless him and honor him, he has one of the most honorable roles in this world. One of the greatest roles that one can ever engage in. When our uncle, Haji Umar, is calling the adhan, right? The adhan is better than any lecture, any reminder anyone can give you. It is the greatest message. Have you ever thought about the adhan when you were hearing the adhan? Reflect on the words of the adhan. Forget about even reflecting on the adhan. Do you know that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he tells us that before we actually start the salah, we start takbirat al-ihram, you're in a state of salah. It starts off prior to even the adhan. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, said, when one of you is going to the salah, do not put your fingers together like this. Why? Because he's in salah. This is just like to do in the salah. It's as if you're in the prayer. He said, when one of you is waiting for the prayer, he's sitting, he's waiting for the prayer, it is as if he's in salah. Prior to the prayer itself, it is as if you're in the salah itself, preparing you spiritually for that prayer. But the adhan, ayyuhal ikhwa, the adhan is extremely great, it's significant. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam tells us when it's called, who's your biggest enemy in salah? Shaitan. When the adhan is called, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam tells us that shaitan, he becomes enraged and he runs and he flees, humiliated from the place that the adhan is called in. It's your first protection from your enemy who's going to try to ruin your prayer. But not only that, you know, we struggle a lot of the time to focus on our prayers. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he told us that an individual will pray the salah and he only get a tenth of it, ninth of it, eighth of it, seventh of it. Or some people get nothing, no reward from the salah based on how much of the salah they were present, they were focusing. We tend to struggle with that khushu' and focusing, concentrating in the salah. There's a secret to attaining the full reward. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said in hadith, listen to this hadith, he said that the muadhin, when he calls the adhan, everything and everyone who hears his voice will seek forgiveness for him. That's number one. That's the first virtue. Is that it? No. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he told us on top of that, that everyone who comes to pray with him, he gets their reward. If 100 people come and pray that salah that he called the adhan to, he gets the reward of 100 people's salah. 1,000 people come, he gets 1,000 people. 2,000, he gets their reward. This is the way to get the full reward. But the one may say, but we don't call the adhan. How can I get that virtue? Only Hajj Umrah is getting this. Are you only speaking to Hajj Umrah, ya Yahya? La, ya jama'ah. You can get the full reward as well. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiyallahu anhuma came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and said, Ya Rasulullah, dhahab al-mu'adhinuna bil-ujur. He said, the muaddins, they've taken all the good reward. All the good reward, they've taken it, Ya Rasulullah. What's left for us? So the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said to him, do you want to know how you can attain the exact same reward as the muaddin? Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, I would love to know. He said, when the muaddin is calling the adhan, when you say the same as the muaddin, you get the exact same reward. Fadlullahi wasi'. Look at the rahmah of Allah. You get the full reward of all those who attended the Fajr reflection, Salat al-Fajr. There's more. That adhan, Allahu tabaraka wa ta'ala, I'm not even guilty into the salah, because if we just reflect to the adhan, it will help you establish that sweetness and that khushu' in the salah. And the last few days I've been all over the country, and this is what I've been talking about, and I thought I'll share it with you guys as well. The adhan, the words of the adhan, have you ever reflected on that? The muaddin is saying, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Allah is greater than all those affairs that you're engaging in right now. Allah is greater than your sleep. Allah is greater than your work. Allah is greater than your studies. Allah is greater than your families. Allah is greater than your business. All these matters that you're engaging in, Allah is greater than that. Come to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, because everything you're seeking is in the hands of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah will grant you it. If you show and you venerate Allah Azza wa Jal in your heart and you turn to Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah will grant you it. Allah will bless you. Allah will protect you. Allah will bestow His favors upon you. Allahu Akbar. Come to Allah immediately. That's what He's saying to you. But the moment you hear Allahu Akbar and you don't come to the salah and you don't show that Allah is great in these matters, that shows that you are worshipping that which you engage in right now. And then he says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, I bear witness that there's no deity worthy of worship except Allah. Sincerity, you're coming for Allah, worshipping Allah, seeking the reward of Allah, seeking the pleasure of Allah, Jalla fi ula. And this is a condition for your ibadah to be accepted, ikhlas. He's reminding you of that. And then he said, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, that you're worshipping Allah the way Muhammad alayhi salatam taught you. You're praying the salah the way Muhammad alayhi salatam taught you. Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray the way you have seen me pray, he said, internally and externally. You imitate him in your salah. He said to you, then he says, Hayya ala salah. Now listen to this. The rest of the adhan, when he was saying it, you were repeating the same as him, right? But when he said, Hayya ala salah, Hayya ala al-falah, what did you say? La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Why? I had the thought, why? The rest of the adhan, I'm saying the exact same thing. But when he gets to hayya ala salah, come to the salah, hayya ala al-falah, come to success, I say, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There's no power and might except with Allah. Why do I say that? It is as if you're saying that without the assistance of Allah and without the power of Allah and without the help of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, I will not be able to come to the salah. I will not be able to come to that success. In order for me to come to that salah, to perform that salah properly, to attain that success, I need the help of Allah. I need the assistance of Allah. I need the aid of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to get there. Therefore, I seek it from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I'm saying that my feet will not be able to come to the masjid if it wasn't for the might and the power of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. It is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala who favored me. It is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala who chose me. It is Allah Azza wa Jal who bestowed His favors upon me and allowed me to wake up this morning and come to Salat al-Fajr in the masjid. So I say, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. It is not me, Yahya. It is not Muhammad. It is not Ali. It is not Ahmed. It is Allah who chose me. Therefore, I all the blessings I attributed to Allah alone. And I say that it's not my power, it's not my ability. Allah chose me. I'm grateful to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I disassociate myself from my power, my might, my ability, and I clench onto the ability and the might and the power of Allah jalla fi'ula. That's the mu'min. But then he says to you, again, if he wasn't sufficient at the beginning, Allahu Akbar, he repeats again. Reminder, if you haven't left what you're doing yet, leave it now. Allah is greater than that. La ilaha illallah, you're doing it for Allah. You're seeking the pleasure of Allah, the reward of Allah. That's what you're going to get. The adhan itself, ayyuhal kiram, it is perhaps better than any lecture, any lesson, any reminder anyone can give you. Sufficient if we only just paid attention to it. There are secrets in these ibadat that Allah tabarak wa legislated prior to the prayer. Shall I stop there or shall I give you more? Do you want more? No, you don't want more. I've spoken for too long. I'll give you one key. This key, if you implement it in your salah, inshaAllah ta'ala, it will make your salah even sweeter. Three statements. Remember these three statements. Speak to him. Conversate with him. Ask him. Speak to Allah. Conversate with Allah. Ask Allah. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu arda'ah, he says that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that one of you, when he enters the prayer, فَإِنَّمَا يُنَاجِي رَبَّهِ, he's conversating with his Lord. Speak to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Some of the Salaf, they would enter the salah and they would go to sujood, and then when they go to sujood, he would say, إِلَهِ أَعَبْدُكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ أَمْ فِي النَّارِ, my Lord, is your slave in Jannah or in the hellfire? And then you ask Allah for Jannah and seek refuge in Allah from the hellfire. Speak to Allah in the salah. Because that conversation you're having in the salah is not one-sided. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala responds. فَإِذَا قَالَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ قَالَ اللَّهُ حَمَدَنِي عَبْدِي. Allah says, my slave has praised me. الرحمن الرحيم أثنى علي عبدي. Allah responds to you in the salah. Glorify Allah. Show Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that you engage in that prayer. When is the time that the people, they tend to have the most khushu' in their salah? Which time of the year? Ramadan, huh? Ramadan. Which salah in particular in Ramadan did they have the most khushu'? Salat al-qiyam, al-taraweeh, the night prayer, right? Which part of the night prayer do people tend to become most emotional and they cry and so on? Which part of the salah? Of taraweeh, for instance. Huh? Which part of it do people tend to cry and become very emotional? In the dua al-qunut and witr. Why is it people, they become so engaged and they start crying in dua al-qunut when the imam is calling upon Allah, making dua to Allah Azza wa Jalla? It's because they implemented this secret, this key, and they don't even know it. They've implemented it. They become so engaged and connected and they start crying. They pour out their hearts to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Why? It's because they know when the imam is making dua, that the imam is speaking on their behalf. He's asking Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. He's asking Allah for Jannah. He's asking Allah to protect them from hellfire. He's asking Allah for forgiveness, his mercy, and so on. And they're engaged and they start crying and they become emotional. Why? Because they know that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is listening to them and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is responding to them and is going to grant them a response. Therefore, they become emotional. They are connected in that prayer. Do we not know that every single part of the prayer is just like that? If you are like that throughout the whole prayer, you will have that feeling throughout the prayer. That's the key. If you just change your perspective and your mindset in the salah, your whole salah will change. Speak to him, conversate with him, and ask him. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to make us those who perfect their prayers. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to grant us the sweetness of the salah. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to make us from those who attain khushu' in their prayers. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to aid us and assist us in his gratitude and his remembrance and the perfection of his worship. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to grant us sincere repentance before we die. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to grant us a good end that's pleasing to him. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to guide us and to increase us in guidance and to guide others through us. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to make us from those who attain beneficial knowledge and act upon their knowledge. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to protect us from his calamities and fitan and trials, the apparent ones and the hidden ones. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to purify our hearts and to rectify our hearts. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to attach our hearts only to him and no worldly matters. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to grant us sincerity in our statements and actions. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to grant us taqwa and to accept our deeds. And we ask Allah jalla fi'ula to protect us from the punishment of the hellfire. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to allow us to reach the blessed month of Ramadan. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to allow us to reach the blessed month of Ramadan whilst we are in good state of iman and health. And we ask Allah jalla fi'ula علاه. Just like you united us here this morning, that unites us in Jannah al-Firdaws al-A'la with our parents and our loved ones and all those who have rights upon us, and to grant us that Jannah without any previous punishment or any difficult account. إنه لذلك والقادر عليه وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين.